In electrolytic conductance, we have completed the number of terms, and at the last video, I have sent you that the application of electrolytic conductance measurement. So friends, before going to discuss the next theoretical part, that is the moving boundary method and velocity of ions, I just take break with some problems. Okay, this is our first problem from the exercise, and one of the our friend can ask me, ma'am, how to solve this problem. So I just take this one first. The problem is that the resistance of DC normal solution of a salt occupying a volume between two platinum electrode 1.80 centimeter apart and 5.4 centimeter square in area was found to be 32 ohm. Calculate lambda. In short, I have right here. Actually, calculate what is the equivalent conductance. So friends, let's start. Before going to solve this problem, you should understand that what is the things are given and what they want to ask us. Okay. So friends, look toward this. In this numerical, they given to us DC normal solution, means what? Concentration is given. Okay, DC normal means what? 0.1 molar solution. So this is the concentration is given in the word form, and we will be do the mistake here. So you should be understand. Okay, now the next one is occupying a volume between two platinum electrode, and that is the 1.80 centimeter apart. Means what? The two electrode is apart from each other, and the area between two electrode is also given. Means length and area is given. Length is 1.80 centimeter, and area is 5.4 centimeter square. So friend, length is given, area is given. What you remember? Yeah, cell constant. This length and area, by using this one, we are able to find out the cell constant. Now next one, they want to ask us find out the equivalent conductance. So friend, how to find out equivalent conductance? We should know the equation related to that. That is lambda, means equivalent conductance, is equal to specific conductance into 1000 upon concentration. So this is the equation. So friends, we know the concentration, but we don't know the specific conductance. Therefore, by using the cell constant, we will be first find out the specific conductance, and then that specific conductance value we will substitute in this equation, and we get the answer for equivalent conductance. Let's start. First, you calculate the cell constant, that is length upon area. 1.80 upon 5.4, and you will be get the answer. Wait a minute, I'll just take calcium. The answer for this, three or four threes. Now, specific conductance is nothing but cell constant upon resistance. So friend, look, there is resistance is also given, that is a 32 ohm, and I am right here, 32 ohm. As I substitute the value of cell constant and substitute the value of resistance, I will get the answer of specific conductance, that is 0.0104. What is the unit of specific conductance? Oh, per ohm per centimeter, or mho per centimeter. This is the answer for specific conductance. Now friend, here we will be get the value of specific conductance as a substitute this value into the our next equation, that is the equivalent conductance, lambda is equal to 1000 into specific conductance 0.0104 upon 1000, upon 0.1. Then after multiplying this 1000 into 0.0104 is equal to 10.4. I thought it is visible for you. And this term is divided by 0.1 molar concentration, and I will be get here 104 equivalent conductance. Okay, 104 equivalent conductance for the this numerical. And what is the unit of equivalent conductance? Yes. Now look toward this. This is the mole per liter. This is the concentration. Means what per mole is add in this mole? More per centimeter per mole. This is the unit of equivalent conductance. Now friend, we will be solve the next number of numerical. Let's see.